I am not comfortable running ad campaigns on my own, and I'd rather not hire someone to do it. It feels risky and it feels expensive if it doesn't work out. So you can imagine the delight in discovering a new AI-powered tool to run your Facebook, Instagram, and Google ad campaigns for you. I am thrilled. It only takes a few minutes to set up. Let's dive right in. You're gonna love this. I'm Phil Pallen, a brand strategist. Welcome to my channel, where I promise practical advice to build your brand. Today, I am seriously so excited to dive into an AI-powered tool to run your multi-channel ad campaigns. So think Facebook, Instagram, Google, all covered for you. It is called Otis. Meet Otis, the tool to help you create cross-channel ads to get in front of your ideal audience. This technology gives you instant customer engagement scores. It allows you to publish campaigns across major social media platforms. It is the perfect tool if you are wanting to grow your followers, scale your business, or increase leads and sales. Okay, we're gonna jump in and take a look, starting with creating your custom audiences. Before we start creating, I'll show you what your dashboard will look like at a high level. Something like this, showing you all of your ads running. Remember, Otis has cross-platform functionality. You see everything in one place. The majority of your budget goes to the best performing ad, which is going to give you the highest return. Since you'll be starting from scratch, like me, your dashboard will probably look like this at the beginning. We'll go ahead and click Create Campaign up here, and we're going to begin defining our audience. The first thing I want you to do is select your goal for the campaign. The first option is generate leads. This will be useful for a lot of people to find potential customers. Your default call to action is learn more. You also have the option to select sell products or services. Pretty straightforward. Your default call to action here is shop now. Collect signups is another option. So people signing up or registering for your business, the call to action for this would be sign up. Pretty straightforward. And finally, a goal might be to build brand awareness. So creating ads for people to know about you. The call to action here would be learn more. For this specific example, I'm going to choose sell products or services. As a branding agency owner and as someone with products like consultations, that's what we'll set ads up for today, as well as courses. I think this is probably the one I would use the most, but know that all of these are great options. Next, we'll define who we want to reach. So very simple, you choose existing customers or new customers. Existing customers, these are people that have already interacted with your business, like signing up for emails. You can choose both. For this, I'm purely interested in new customers. So showing my ad to people who are similar to my existing customers, similar interests, increasing the likelihood that they'll buy from me. And next, we can maximize ad performance by selecting a broad location. This doesn't have to be specific. You'll see here, New York City is the example. You would use that instead of Brooklyn. You've also got the advanced option here. So this is more advanced. So you can actually set a mile radius for a particular place. Most of my clients are in main cities like Los Angeles. There we go. New York City. There we go. Let's select this one and I'll add one more. Let's add London. England, there we go. So those three I think are gonna be good. They're broad and that's at least gonna get us started. These are cities where I have the majority of my clients, so that would make the most sense to target. Next, we'll select where you want your ads to appear and you've got a few options. Instagram, Facebook, Google Search, Google Display, or TikTok. I think for this example, I'll stick with the first three, Instagram, Facebook, and Google Search. Finally, you might be using some of these apps, and Otis provides an integration with them. Square, Shopify, Clover, MailChimp, QuickBooks, WooCommerce, Wix, or you've got your traditional CSV file here where you can upload this with customer data. And they've also got a template here to build your audience. That's very, very useful. So once you've created your audience, it's time to select who you want to target and which channels you want to publish on. So let's look at that right now. So let's move to the next stage by clicking continue up here. And now we'll focus on creative. I pre-populated this a little bit to make it easier and faster. Here we would name our campaign. And here we would choose from three options. Continue building your ad. This is something I already started. You can choose from ready-made templates, which I'll show you really quickly. And then created for you is another option. You can choose from automatically generated generated templates based on your Facebook and Instagram profiles. Let's click this really quickly, the ready-made templates. Just take a quick look here. This is actually what I started with. So here you can choose from their templates, really organized well here. Holiday menu, book appointments, support small businesses. Basically, you'd find the one that is the closest to what you need. It doesn't have to be a perfect match, but you'd find the closest to what you need. I chose support small businesses. We'll go back and we'll continue with where I was building. So here I uploaded an image under build ad. They say here strong image or video, depending on what you want. So you want high quality images, and you can add actually a few here to make it dynamic and have some options for your ad sets. Here you'll set a landing page. So for this service that I want to sell, it's my brand audit consultation. And here you'd put an exciting headline, your long headline, explain what's unique, and then finally provide a description. So now I will make some changes to these. What I like is that it gives me a little score here so that it inspires me to try and get that score higher. I can select the rephrase button and it will give me some new ways of typing that element. So in this case, the long headline. I can scroll through and see if there's anything that I like better. In this case, I'm happy with what I have, so I'll leave it. But if I wanted to change it, it's as simple as clicking that and adjusting it. Now I'll speed up this portion and add some updates. There, I'm really happy with what I have, and these scores definitely helped and pushed me to keep trying to make the copy better. I definitely love Otis because they're taking care of this. All you really need to bring with you is just good creative, good images and visuals, and the rest is so easy. Let's click continue. Here you'll see a preview of your ad. So it's actually bringing in each of the ads that I selected, right, in the last stage, and it's helping me create a visual. This is so easy. You can click edit and make individual adjustments on each of the ads. You can add more, right? You can adjust it slightly. Let's click save changes. And back here, you can go through each of your ads, and I would recommend doing that. I'm really happy with what I see. I'm actually gonna unselect responsive display. But let's keep Google search ads there. I'm really, really happy with that. So let's go ahead and click continue. And here you'll choose your plan. So I'm going to stick with the Essentials plan, which is $50 billed monthly plus 12% of the ad spend. Your other option is the Pro plan, which is $250, a little more billed monthly plus 10% of the ad spend. I'll talk about the different plans toward the end. But for this example, we're going to choose Essential and we're going to get rocking. Finally, let's talk about now launching your ads. Here it's recommending a $25 ad spend per day. The lowest is 15. Really going below that, you're not gonna see results. So I'm gonna leave this at 25. If I wanted, I could go higher. Maybe I wanna run this ad at $50. That would be 350 a week. You will then see here a billing breakdown. So your ad spend, subscription fees, and then the service fees that Otis will charge. This looks good. I'll edit my payment method and then click launch. Honestly, the good news is the hard part is over. Now it's autopilot time. You can focus on your work while Otis adjusts the budget to improve performance. This is so great. We are off to the races. Now, as you can see, my ad has only been live for a few hours. I've spent $9, I've had 10 clicks, and I love this really simple breakdown of impressions, cost per click, and click-through rate. These are very important, and I love that it's simplifying this in a beautiful, clean snapshot across platforms so I can understand it without being an overly technical person, which is what I am. This is the dashboard. If I want more specific information, I click onto my campaign. While you're busy doing work, Otis is dynamically adjusting your budget to improve the performance. And also it'll provide AI recommendations in real time. So here, for example, Facebook, it's performing the best. So Otis is allocating the most of my ad spend here. I absolutely love this. It's so simple to track, and obviously a few days further, it's gonna give me more information, but I thought it was cool to see how much has happened even in a few hours since starting my campaign. So that is Otis. Yes, they were my partner to create this video, but they have turned me into a customer because I'm absolutely thrilled with the results. I anticipate using this in several ways to grow my business. Definitely check out the link in the description. If you've got any lingering questions, comment below. Let's keep the conversation going on down there. I respond to those personally. And if you enjoyed this video, give it a like. That helps other people discover these videos, which we work hard to create for you. And subscribe for more of my videos on branding, positioning, building, and promoting your brand. Thank you, Otis, for partnering with me to create this video. It's been a lot of fun. Next, I'm sharing a few videos I think you'll be interested in. I'm Phil Pallen. Thanks for watching. Those are coming up next.